제101회 이렇게 재밌을 줄 몰랐어.
안녕하세요. Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Speak Korean. I'm your host Lisa Kelly and welcome to our 102nd episode. And who knew that it'd be this fun learning Korean? You know, come here 10 minutes a day, just pick up a line or two or review over something that you've already learned. Great, right? 이렇게 재밌을 줄 몰랐어요. Okay, I really didn't expect it either. That was our main expression for today. And 이렇게 멋있을 줄 몰랐어요. I thought he was just like a nerd, but...
오버하지 마. Okay. She's starting again. Yeah, Lisa, thank you for switching. I had it upside down. Yeah, okay, now I've got it straight. Hello, everybody. 안녕하세요. I'm Stephen Revere. Thank you all for being with us. We'll teach you how to talk about your expectations and how you got much more than you expected or much less than you expected. Mm-hmm. And we've gotten much more than we expected with both our students.
안녕하세요, 네오미입니다.
안녕하세요, 사미입니다.
Yeah. Okay, well, you know, this is a pretty fun expression. You know, up until now, we've had lots of expressions, useful expressions that we kind of need for our life here in Korea. But here, we have something kind of fun that we can use with our friends, okay? 이렇게 재밌을 줄 몰랐어요. Let's go find out what we're going to learn today.
Let's do it!
한국 생활이 어때?
정말 재미있어. 이렇게 재미있을 줄 몰랐어.
Okay, the first expression we heard there was 한국 생활이 어때? Okay, how is 어때? Your life in Korea, your lifestyle in Korea, how's everything flowing here in Korea? You might hear this a lot when you're living here from foreigners. And instead of saying 한국 생활, you can say 내 옷 어때? 뭐 내 얼굴 오늘 어때? 뭐 how's my hair today? 머리 어때? This is something we use a lot, right?
And I always think of the word 생활 as like daily lifestyle, right? Daily lifestyle, the way you live. Another word that we could give you that works in that 생활, 사생활, which is private life, personal life, the things that you keep to yourself. 사생활. So sometimes you could say, you know, oh, they're invading my privacy.
Right.
You
know, oh, or I like to say, I like to keep my privacy. So 사생활 보호하고 싶어요. I want to
protect my privacy.
Right. Mm-hmm. Here in Korea, it's like everyone wants to, you know, ask you questions and talk to you.
Age. Everybody always wants to know. Right. Lisa, I still don't know Lisa's age. She refuses to tell me.
Top secrets. Anyways, and the expression we hear after that is
어때, right? Then they said 어때. How is life in Korea? Now, we've had 어때 before, right? I tend to just think of it as how. Sometimes you say 어떻게, right? Mm-hmm. We've had that before. 어떠 ends in the 히읗 at the bottom and then 게. And originally, it's 어떠 and then 해, right? But the real pronunciation is 어떻게, and that's how do you do something, right? You're talking about doing something, so you add to do at the end.
And here's something that, okay, we got lots of pretty cookies here that they prepare. Could you taste one for me?
Sure.
And then I can ask Stephen, 어때?
어때?
How is it? How's it taste? You can just use it alone like this. Mm. That's what we eat. It's pretty good. 어때?
Very good.
Okay.
Very good.
맛있어.
아주 맛있어.
Okay, and then the answer we had is 정말 재밌어. Okay, we all know this. It's really fun. Fun. They like to use the word 재미, fun. Usually we would say it's very interesting, it's very good, it's wonderful. But 재밌다, it's all-inclusive. It means it's very interesting. It's very wonderful.
And the word 정말 is used just the same way as it is in English, right? Really. So sometimes somebody will tell you something that you find hard to believe. Oh, 저 사람은 서른 살이야.
정말?
That person is 30, right? And then you would go, 와, 정말? I find that hard to believe. Oh, really? I can't believe it. And then the other person would respond. Well, how would the person respond? 진짜, right?
아니면 정말.
Really? Yeah, you could respond. Yeah. 정말?
Really?
Or you could say 진짜, which is, yes, that's totally true.
Okay, and let's get into our main expression for today. We're going for 를 줄 몰랐어 is our main format. And today's expression, I didn't know it'd be this fun. Now, 재미, like I said, it can also mean interesting or wonderful. So we're saying, I didn't know Korea would be this wonderful, okay? 이렇게 재미일 줄 몰랐어요.
Right. You throw on your adjective there, your descriptive verb, as some people say in Korea. You throw on your adjective, and you just put an 으 at the end of it if it does not have a 받침, right? But if it does have a 받침, then you're going to have to change it to 으. 매울 줄 몰랐어, we just had, right? 이렇게 매울 줄 몰랐어. 맵다 is an irregular verb. We've been over these irregular 비읍 verbs over and over. The 비읍 drops away and turns into an 우. So it goes 매울 줄 몰랐어. Oh, I couldn't, didn't know it was going to be so spicy.
Can you think of something else you could say?
영화가 이렇게 재미있을 줄 몰랐어요.
Very good.
한국어가 이렇게 재미있을 줄 몰랐어요.
Very good, yeah.
And Stephen, I want an example for you.
재미있을 줄 몰랐어, right? You got to put the 쌍시엣 and the 쌍지엣 in there. Make those sound a little 재미있을 줄 몰랐어. Very good, very good.
An example from you?
An example from me. You know what always happens when people finally do meet me in person on the street? I always hear, 와, 스티븐이 이렇게 키가 작을 줄 몰랐어. And that's what I always hear. I had no idea you were so short, which I am rather short, ladies and gentlemen. About 167 centimeters and 5'6", for those of you from North America.
Okay. Well, you never had to say that. You never stand up here.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Well, let's cover the 줄 here. You can use it in a different form. For example, 줄 안다, like 알다. I know how to do something. For example, 한국말 할 줄 알아요. I know how to speak Korean. Do you know how to drive, Steve?
Yes. 운전할 줄 알아요.
Oh,
yes.
Good.
And then another way you can use this one, let's say, in the past tense, if you use it in the past tense, because you saw something happened, let's say, I know Lisa stayed out really late last night. Then Lisa comes in late this morning. Then I could say, ah, Lisa got 늦을 줄 알았어. I knew she would be late. I know this never happens.
No. 사생활 보호 좀 하고 싶어요. I want to protect my private life.
그냥 예를 들어주는 거예요. 걱정 마세요. It's just an expression. Just giving somebody a new expression, an example.
Actually, that's what we say about you all the time. Anyways, let's go on to Let's Wrap It Up.
Wrap It Up
with Lisa
and Steven.
청소가 이렇게 재미있을 줄 몰랐어.
정말 그렇게 재미있어?
정말 재미있어. 이렇게 재미있을 줄 몰랐어.
아, 그럴 줄 알았어. I knew that was gonna happen.
Yeah, what can I say? I love cleaning.
I love cleaning.
And one thing for you guys to notice there, 청소하다, notice, that is to clean. But then if you put 청소, it just becomes a noun. A lot of words in Korean start out as nouns, then you add 하다 to them to turn them into verbs. Yeah. But in English, it's the opposite, right? Usually there's a verb, and then you add ing, or you add T-I-O-N or something to make it into a noun. Korean usually works in the opposite direction.
Okay. Well, having said that, let me ask you, and you can honestly tell me what you feel, okay? 한국 생활이 어때요?
이렇게 재밌을 줄 몰랐어요.
I didn't ask for our expression, but thanks anyway. Honestly, 솔직히 말해주세요, okay? 한국 생활이 어때요?
이렇게 재미있을 줄 몰랐어요.
Hey! It's not on the script!
But
or we have to go by the script now?
No, I'm just kidding. I was thinking I'd hear some different answers, but really, almost 99% of all the foreigners that I know love living in Korea. They think it's fun. There's lots of great food, lots of great places to see, to visit, and lots of great hangouts, right? Steve is living in...
I wouldn't say 99%,
but I know a lot of people. Actually, you live in Hangout Central, too.
Okay?
Yes. 이렇게 재밌지 몰랐죠? I'm sure you didn't know it would be this fun. Please come back next time for another 10 minutes here at Let's Speak Korean. See you then. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. And in the meantime, IronTV.com.